Here's a building. On the other side of this building, there's a spot for these two freight cars that need to be delivered to. So I'm on my way back after checking that out. And now I know where to deliver these two. I can climb back into my engine, and the conductor and I can finish up our switching for the day, or for the morning, I should say. We'll take our break and go on to the next. Take a seat here. And hopefully you got to watch part one of the switching, where we dropped off most of the cars. But in this, we will be doing a runaround. We've got the engine in neutral, and let's get it set up to go here. Here's our map, and looking at our buildings, kind of straddles those tracks. We need to make our way back away from our ways to do our runaround. I'll show you how that works here as we go. Put it in reverse, ease up on the air brakes. One notch, and we're off. Open up the window. So there's our, once again, there's the building we're going to deliver to. We need some goods out of our box cars. Make our way down the track here. We have two cars left. From the first video, we delivered a series of different types of cars, a fuel tanker and some other tank cars and some poppers. Now we got these two box cars left. Coming up on our runaround track here. Careful. I'm going to send out the conductor. The conductor is riding the back of the train. And I should say he's riding the far boxcar. Ready to get out and throw some switches. Give me the okay and when I should stop. So from the conductor's perspective, we got a number of switches to throw. This is kind of like playing a game of chess. We want to think two or three moves ahead. We're going to throw that one and a few more while we're out doing a walk. These two can go stay straight the way they are. And this track is going to take us over to the other side. You can see our building's way out there now. And we're going to think this through. The better we think and plan, the less moves we have to make. So the engineer will start bringing the train down the track while I make my walk and take care of as many of these switches I can throw while I'm making the walk. Yep, I think that's good. As you know, I'm in the camera view 3, so I'm able to walk around like this. I'm sorry, I'm in actually the free cam. Free cam is keyboard number 8. It's a camera view 8, I would say. I'm going to throw that one because we're going to need to come over to this side through here. After we make the runaround, so we got to leave this one switch up ahead straight for the time being. And you can see it's green over to the right. And Looking back, that one's red, that's good. So what we're doing, when we say run around, what we want to do is run the engine around these two boxcars so we're on the other side of these boxcars. Because we have a facing point switch if we were to go at it now, and we need to make it a trailing point switch. And so I'm going to go ahead and put the handbrake on so they don't run off on us. Cut these cars loose. There we go. I'm going to jump from the free cam to the camera view 3, which kind of allows us to ride the step here. Kind of ride the stoop while we break away from the cut. And once we pass the points, I can jump off and switch this over. Remember from the first video, I got all my settings, my graphic settings on low in order to get better frame rates and performance. Well, I kind of blew past my points. Told you I was gonna go past it, but got the talking and forgot again. So we'll jump off, get back with the free cam. Yeah, it's kind of awkward with camera view bouncing around like this, but that's what we are doing. Make the switch, and we can hang here until the engine comes back up. As I was telling you before, I like to think of the HUD as my radio, my portable radio for my communication with the engineer. And that way we can let the engineer know what we're doing. And that's the way I like to think of it. Yeah, what I want to do is I want to switch this straight again while I'm here, so I don't have to jump off later. Because we're coming back through this way, as you will learn once I run around those boxcars. Get the engine in front. Yeah, so into the cab now from the engineer's perspective. Let the conductor ride the stoop and head on over and get on past. So it's a real simple maneuver. You just have to find two parallel tracks where you have enough space to run around the number of cars you got. Too straight, that's good. I already made the switch for the curve, but the far switch on the left track, I need to stop going at 10 miles an hour here. Slow this baby down. I need to stop and switch it. Come on now. There we go. Let's see if we caught it in time. Back out to the free cam. Yep, I'm able to switch it. Go ahead and have the engineer take us on past. Yeah. What I was saying in the previous video is I got all the graphic settings on low, but I've discovered by switching my Train Sim World install from a mechanical drive to a solid state drive, I was able to not able to do it in this video. I did the two videos first, and then I made this discovery that I can increase my frame rates and load up higher graphic settings and still get better frame rates. And that's fantastic that I can do that. So in future videos, we can have a little bit nicer, higher graphic settings, and still even have nice, well, my frame rates, this is a laptop, my frame rates aren't that good, but they're right under 30. But there we are. We just performed a run around, and we got a couple back up again. Yeah, so to do this, you need two parallel tracks where you can, with two switch points, where you can get around your line of cars that you're trying to move the engine to the other side of. So, this is quite a common maneuver. It takes time. It's not preferred because it does take time, but sometimes it's the only option in order to drop off the cars to a facing point. The only option really to drop cars off to a facing point spur would be to run around it somewhere and then come back, and then once you run around it, you'll turn into a trailing point. So what a lot of engineers do is they'll drop off all the trailing point cars first, then they get to the end of their delivery line, they'll run around the train, and then they come back and hit all the facing points, because they'll now be on the way home would be trailing points. So let's couple up here. Well, a little more. Good enough. Get down and check this out. Engine looks good. Let's see. Yeah, I got this R box car I had set the handbrake on. Gonna free that up. Get on my radio, let him know that that's done. And I can climb up here. Yeah, I already set that ahead of time. And I'm climbed up the ladder now. And you can see why I wanted to hang around before and set that point straight, so because we're going to back up right over it. And then we're going to head on to the other side of the yard once we get the engine passed. Yeah, so this is quite a common maneuver, but like I said, it's not preferred. It takes a little time to run around, and especially if you have a long one. This is in the yard, we found one that's fairly short, that we didn't have to go a half a mile or a mile or something to perform the maneuver. So that was the good news. We have plenty of switching opportunities in the yard to do so. So as a conductor, I'll jump off. Okay, come on, a little more. Let him get past the points, switch it on over, and then I'll get back on again. One of the things I forgot to talk about in the first video was what scenario I'm playing. Actually, there's a set of services and there's a set of scenarios. The very last scenario in the heavy haul route is one that is a free-to-play. You can see up in the left-hand corner where the HUD says free-to-play. That free-to-play allows you to freely move around the yard and do whatever you want. But you can't get out of the yard. And that's disappointing that you can't really escape the yard. So the tracks that are behind me that we're moving away from now, they kind of go to a bunch of switch points that are non-operational, so you can't get past there, which is unfortunate because it looks like there are switches back there that that have spurs going somewhere. I can't even walk. I tried to walk past it, and it's the end. It's really the end of the environment, so you can't walk past it. So I made my switch. I need to run up ahead of the train and start throwing this switch now, which I needed to go straight before to go back over to the left. Now I need to move over to the right rails and keep maneuvering till I can get to the place where I can cross from one half of the yard ladder to the other half of the yard ladder. And so, as you can see, a conductor is on his feet a lot, running around quite a bit. And in doing so, it would just make sense if we can be in the walk mode instead of the free cam mode. But as I had mentioned in probably several videos now, my disappointment that in the walk mode, you cannot operate the engine. So you have to be in the free cam mode or camera 3, one of the camera modes, in order to bring the HUD up and run the engine. Basically sitting your walker in the engineer's seat in order for this to happen. And so, I'm in the free-to-play scenario. The only thing is the free-to-play, it actually puts you out on the tracks in the early evening. So you only have a couple hours of play time. A couple hours of switching cars and doing whatever you're going to do before it goes dark. So if you probably noticed, it's actually early morning and I'm in the free to play. And so I just left it running one night and went to sleep, got up, and just left Train Sim World running in this scenario, and then came back and saved it in the morning. So I can always come back and do the free to play and have all day to switch around the yard. In fact, when I started, I checked my fuel level. It was like 1390. That was the fuel level in this engine I'm running. And when I get done, I'll check it after switching out from part one several cars, and this second part switches last two. We'll see how much fuel I used, and in the future I'll just continue my saves from here. I think really what I decided to do, I hadn't done this yet, but create another profile and call the other profile career, and get back and make this really my career, and I can do all my achievements in the original profile. So I'm going to jump out here, and I'm going to think this through, whether or not I need to switch this one, of course, because he's coming along from the other side of the yard going to this ladder set. And I need to go to the left, so I'm going to switch this one. And we're just going to curve right around here. And I'm going to do some magic and switch from camera view 3, which you can actually move out away from the train a little bit, about this far, camera view 3. But not any further than that. And of course, you're always attached with camera view 3, which means when the engine starts moving, I would have been moving. But I did a little magic and I switched from camera view 3 to free cam, which is the 8 key. Yeah, I keep repeating that. Now I just jump back to camera view 3. So between those two keys, it's a nice workaround, and you can really enjoy doing the conductor's tasks. So I need to go to the left side of the building. You can't go through those doors. I know in Train Simulator 2017 there is some downloadable content, some payware, where doors open up and you can actually drive in the engine house and warehouse and any other kind of place. Because their rails go right through this building. One of the things you're not able to see in map view, you don't see any buildings, all you do is see rails. Anyway, I'm going to run around the side of the building. Continue on here. And then I have to get to the other side, the right side. You see where that silo is? That outside tank. The vertical tank, not the horizontal one. And there's a track on that side of the building that has an end spur. So I'm only gonna park those two freight cars there. So I want to be careful coming through here. Could be people walking out. Keep a watchful eye out for anybody in our imaginary world that could have been coming out. Somebody made a comment to one of my videos, if this was a really, really thought out simulation, they'd have some people walking around and some workers for sure. Actually, I think in the next piece of Train Sim World coming out, the Great Western, with the passenger lines, they're going to have quite a few people walking around. So I'm looking forward to seeing how much that does occur. And I did the pre-order with the big reduction on the price. It's crazy how much you can spend on these train simulators if you buy all the downloadable content. This is a crazy amount of money. And it looks like Train Sim World is going along the same path of getting you. Every time you put another little piece onto it. I mean, you have to. I mean, unless you just say, hey, I'm not going to bother with this simulation. It's not good enough. It doesn't have the spots. It doesn't have the industries. It doesn't have a long enough route. And just not bother with it. But I love train simulating, so... I'm into it, and I already got the pre-order, so I wish there was another route for U.S., but I'll enjoy the London Western route, U.K. Maybe I'll learn a little bit about what the Brits are doing. So as a conductor, I kind of jumped off here, waiting for the train to get the car past the point, and then we can back our train now. And you can see why the engine needs to be on this side, the side that it's at, instead of the original side. So I now have a trailing point. And we can back up into it and drop him off. But he's not far enough. He's still sitting on top of the points. This is kind of a difficult place too. You would have to check with the yard, I don't know what you call him, the yard master or whatever, make sure there wasn't any trains coming down that half. Because the engine's almost going into that next set of ladders. But yeah, it is kind of funky with the camera, trying to use camera view. And that's why I keep saying over and over again, it would really be nice if we can walk, the conductor can walk and do conductor tasks. But as I pointed out, only the engineer can get up and walk around. Easily remedied if we're given keyboard commands to run the engine while we're walking. So if that's possible, someone out there, please listen and give us those abilities. So bringing up my virtual radio, I am able in camera view to communicate with the engine and tell him he's free to come on back. And I can just relax here for a moment while I wait for the fact. I want to get on the other side so I'm not pinned up against the building or any crates or boxes that are over there. in the loading area. So let's get over on this side, and then we can jump on the train. And get them to slow down a little bit, kind of a moving jump. Yeah, now we're good to go. Yeah, so the crazy thing was I went into the last scenario of this pack, and it's the only free to play, and let it go through the night, saved it, and now I'm doing my saves during during these sessions now. And after I get done dropping these off, I'll do another save, and then I can continue on and keep switching whatever static freight cars are available. I told you before, there's not many, but there are some. But I can just keep pushing cars around here until I get bored with it. Yeah. And at some point, I'm going to say, okay, where's the downloadable content where I can actually deliver cars to another city and then deliver them into industry spots. So this is actually kind of a nice spot, and it definitely is somewhere that you would deliver to here in the yard. You can see the crates and the pallets of goods, and I'm going to bring it right on down along the side of the building. There's actually a roll-up door towards the end. I'll try to get the last car over towards that roll-up door. I'll let the engineer know over the radio about four more cars. Three more. Two more. One more. Half a car. That'll do. Yeah, well, got a little close there. Perfect. And, we can cut these cars loose. Forget, we want to let these cars roll and set the handbrake. And then we can do the cut. Good. And we can climb on the stoop here and kind of hang on for the ride. And away we go. Okay, engineer, letting them know that we're moving. Turn the bell on. It's funny, I couldn't hear the bell even though it was on. Turn it off now, but even though the bell was on while I was walking, when I faced away, I couldn't hear it until I started facing towards it, making my way forward. Anyway, I meant to check the fuel level because I'm about ready to park the train. I forgot to check the fuel level. So, at least I didn't catch it on the video, but I did check it, and it came out to 1390. We're at 1370 when I started the day. I wish I would have got that on video, but so I used about 20 gallons of fuel. So it's kind of interesting. I'll continue on and save this. I'm going to park the engine and shut it down, but I'll save it after that, and I'll keep coming back and working the day out, because it's only, I forgot, it's about 8 or 9 in the morning now. Yeah, so finishing up here for this segment. I hope you enjoyed it. we get back on the train, and we got just one last thing to do is switch it back up against the building and park it. So that's what we're running on right now. Yeah, so we're backing up into the up towards the building, and we'll just go ahead and park it here, and then we can shut it down till we get our next test of trains to move around. Go ahead and take our morning break. So what we want to do is shut down. Is we're gonna definitely want to put it in full service on the air brake. Put it in neutral. Turn off the headlights, both front and back lights. And didn't have anything on. Got the gauges on. Turn the gauge lights on, off. I mean, and go ahead and turn off these things for the power and the generator and the fuel pump. Get all that turned off. And we're all parked and ready, and make sure they're full service on the air brake, and get up and shut her down. That's awesome. So hopefully you enjoyed this second part. We did the maneuver. Close up the door, open the window, make sure air stays flowing in there for hot days. Yeah, did the runaround, got the last two boxcars parked, and we're ready to go for next time. So I hope you enjoyed this, and we'll talk to you again.